This is a 1.5 star karma path, the weekly challenge with our 2-star Tahm Kench, level 5. Let's do this, yo. Yeah, so I've been off for a while. I'll be back when the new expansion hits. Until then, we have to play a little, you know, late. I don't want to get burned out before the expansion hits. Yes, sir. So Tahm Kench is level 5. He's super low level. Oh, yeah. So this path's power is stun the strongest and the weakest. So it doesn't make a difference whose units they are, but the strongest card and the weakest card will get stunned every round. Ooh, this is going to be super painful. I don't think our card will ever be the strongest though. Tahm Kench will be the strongest. So we can play the octopus. Can attack. Okay, pull an attack can kill this one. I tried this path with Name 1-star. Name 1-star is so super bad. So wait till Name is at least 2-star. Name is super spell heavy as well. 2-4 gets killed. Okay, play this one. You gotta leave the bay before the ocean. He keeps his mana as well. And we'll have Tahm Kench ready next turn. Play Tahm Kench. Okay, we'll attack and get each other damage first. This thing is 2 mana, right? Play Kench. Go next. Yeah, 1-star champions are super weak. Crazy level weak. They're gonna be fighter. I'll just place some small unit then. They're actually going pretty big, you know, just small units. Block, block, block. Another nibble. What is his original HP? It's alright. Yeah, this doesn't seem like a 1.5 star path. This is the first fight they have this many 4-4s on them. Well, if it ain't the
eyes of the operation. Suppose that makes you the guts, eh, big fella?
Not again. Where there's a will, there's me. Attack. I do enjoy. Yes, regens, I'm not too worried. Happy to do whatever. Let this rally, heal up. Rally again. I mean, attack again. Safety first. Going for phase one, whereas we have heals in our deck. At the moment, eating is not our focus. This guy will finish them off long run anyway, so you just got to keep this guy alive. And take less damage, of course. Hope I didn't mean that. Let us peruse this establishment's fair. Okay. Then we're just gonna eat that one. Oops. Oh wait, this one. Forgot which one it is. Eat it up. Excuse my impertinence. The surviving is +1/+1. That's Tonkin's power. What you looking for? Let me play this one. Just have a blocker. This is actually pretty nice. Pretty crazy, I mean.
What brings you here?
15 damage, yikes. Oh, I could have blocked with this one. I couldn't even see it. I thought this guy is stunned. It's fine. We'll just heal this so that this guy doesn't die and swing and finish them off with this one. Yeah, even with booster Tahm Kench, I'm struggling. Just do this. And before we do this, we do this. He'll face up 8 extra. There we go. Super. Yeah, I took 5 damage extra because I didn't forgot to block with that one. Yeah, but Tahm Kench plays a slow style. 70 damage to face. I'll take minion. Minion is super, in my opinion. Constantly comes back. This is pretty good. Okay, let's see our support squad. Okay, I think I'll take Kill. Kill is super, in my opinion. Everyone is somewhat buffed. Everything that survives is buffed, so I will take Kill. Kill into, yeah, Tahm Kench is 5-4, so it's pretty good. It's not like they're clashing against one another. Okay, shop. Practical perfectionist. And this, we're gonna go for shop side. Shop will get priority. Yeah. Oh, Tahm Kench is super slow. He grows over time, though. Okay, kind of like this. If we can keep this guy alive. Problem is they have Mystic Shot and shit. This is definitely, it's Boardmane, right? Yeah. Boardmane. Well, we definitely have targeted spells in their arsenal. Yes. Okay. I think I'm gonna play this, invest this on. Comes back into my hand. This one? Okay. I can't technically consume this right now. Actually, I can. I can consume this one at least. Because if they flock, even if they flock, I'm surviving. But I can't eat that one. If I try to eat that one and they flock me, I die. Right. Xenomana Sweater. Super. I don't need to attack in that one. I would rather block than attack, right? 4 damage being neglected when they attack is more valuable than you trying to dish out 1 damage. That will die to the unit. Okay. Yeah. Spirit decent. I want to pass and see what they do. Oh, that was an excellent pass by them. Eek. AIs are smarter these days. No. Okay. 6. So let's just play our minion. Legion. Saboteur. No, not Legion. It's Ninja General. Okay.
Suppose that makes you the guts. Hey, big fella? Listen and learn.
Just attack, dish out the damage. I'll just eat that one. This time I'll take the risk because I have this to open. Yeah, so if they don't attack, I'm just gonna stun it. No, never mind, they get all to get stunned. The strongest one gets stunned. Getting. Ah! Man, I'm burning so good guards, dude. Did this one? Yeah, minion has been doing great. Stun the strongest too, okay. I'll just stun. I'll just eat that one then. You had your chance to walk away. I'll take the trades here, by the way. I'm gonna leave a Mihira anyways. Tahm Kench levels up, we'll pay Mihira and block them and just start going on the board next turn. The fact that whatever he consumes he gets is pretty disgusting. I saw that he actually gets champions as well. Unblock this one. I think. Whatever he consumes. Yeah, create a copy in a unit. It doesn't matter if it's champion or normal unit. Yeah, pretty broken. I'll grow everything. Super. Swing does 13 a lot actually. Swing does 17 damage. Absolutely perfect. There we go. Yeah, we burned a Kale and a Mihira, but it's fine. Yeah, but Kale support should be good because it's stall. It's stalling power, so should be fine. Kale is pretty nice. Considering the fact that we take a lot of damage, but yeah, Goat is also fine. You get a portal, so you get a free unit. Okay, I don't really like this one. Well, Sound of Strongest is pretty good for us. I don't have that many spells, or this is actually perfect for Nami Squad. Oh, I don't like any of them. Leave. Go next, take the gold. Might actually go for a heal. If I can get it. No. Next one is still. Nah, you can prioritize heal. You have to go for shop. Okay. Feral Mystic. It should be the painful one. Yeah, the 7 mana, 8 mana, yeah. One. If that stairs comes on lowered. I don't like this one. I don't like this one. I'll take this too for the time being. And hopefully get Tahm Kench. Oh, Mihira is here. Turn 3. Why are we at turn 3? Okay. You gotta leave the base. Why do you get one extra mana?
Where are you getting one extra mana from?
I mean, why are we at 3 mana on turn 1? Okay. Healing. We'll just do this. I'm okay with Tate Street. For the time being, I mean. I'll take this one. Might as well bang the mana if you get Tahm Kench, I gotta display the spell. And play. Actually, I don't have to play this one. Let's play this one for the time being and see what they do. And play this one. Pick an ally. opposite. Super. Absolutely disgusting. Super. And lifesteal. The reason why I did this is because we're gonna play in that stairs and it's good 3 damage to everything. Mihira would die if that happens. That's why. Okay, in that one then. There's nothing I can do, unfortunately. And Mihira will die. Eeh. Actually, Mihira, okay, I can do this then. I'll sacrifice my K. Yeah, I'll sacrifice my K that Mihira survives. This is fine. Remember, you never saw me. Yeah, this is much better. That's 13. We need one more damage. Oh, never mind. It's done. Okay. Be vulnerable to this one. Of course, 3 damage to everything. Okay. And all of them get +1/+1. Good things. I think we got them, yeah. Yeah, I think we got them. Pull. This is also fine. Yeah, there we go. Super. That capture was clutch, and that sacrifice on Kale was also clutch. Yeah, sometimes you don't need your champions. Sometimes the followers are strong enough. Yeah, the sad boost combo is super. I can actually do it with Kale as well. 1 minute draw is pretty nice. 2 minute draw, right? I'll take silence then. Oh, this is also pretty good. I'll take the dragon. The dragons are pretty disgusting here. Okay, champion attachment shop and shop will get priority. We will buy a power. Wanted to is pretty nice. I'll take it. It's a free body on the board. It's actually a power that is way better than it looks. Okay, face off against Sejuani. Should be a little painful. Other than eat, we don't have anything good to remove stuff from the board. Okay, it's fine. 5. So 5/5 challenging. We don't want that. Oh, this is fine. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 6 is bad. We need something for turn 4. This one, goat is pretty good. Okay, they get +1/+1 stat line. Oh, why didn't they attack? Weird. Yeah. Okay, so that's not elusive yet. Pass and see what they do first. The winter's claw strikes. I think I'm just gonna go wider than they are. When I say go wider, I mean go as wide as they are. Oh, it's fine. It doesn't matter because they have impact, right? So the overrun damage going through and leveling up Sejuani is irrelevant. They will get stacks for Sejuani, whether we like it or not. Let's split this one. Because next time when Gale comes, this will get elusive. So when the Kale comes, this will get elusive. Okay, next turn is Sejuani's turn. Fight or die. Ah, this time I will just definitely sweep. Six is actually gonna take on everyone. I'll take everything. There we go, super. This is a very good tempo for us. On things here as well. So that's what Sejuani is gonna come for Kale. Do we have any defense? Unlucky. Yeah. Unfortunately, we don't have any defense. Pass. Oh, it's such a good because Zia is gonna come. Kale is gonna come back from the Haunted Tomb. It's actually super. So we just need one space, right? This one is pretty good. This one will also get elusive. So might as well give it here. So Kale will come from this one and buff everyone. Wait. Why didn't Kale get... I'm super confused. Why didn't Kale come out? Because Kale's original. Oh, because he's a 1-5. Original 1-5. It doesn't count as the double one. Okay, good to know. Oh, there we go. Our rally just finishes them off. Super. Nice. Okay, that's actually good to know. That Haunted Team doesn't work with Kale. Oh, no. Yeah, that was so bad. No, that's actually pretty bad. Like, super bad to be exact. Scout. Yeah. Hilarious if you think about it. Okay. When I'm summoned in power quick attack, does it make a difference? Actually, it does. She's the only one with quick attack. It's more difficult to block someone who kick quick attack scout than Tahm Kench having scout. Critic cost one less, means the things that will consume will cost one less. But when you summon and I give it +1/+1, this is just temporary. I think creator cost one less is much better. Anything we consume will be one less. Two less actually. Spells and item, I think item will get priority. We don't need spells.
Yeah, we're not spell heavy,
so we shouldn't go for spells. We just go for an item. If we get a decent attachment on our units, it could be good. We don't want 5, we don't want 6, we are okay with 2-3. We're looking for Tahm Kench and anything else. Mihira is also pretty good. No, they probably have, yeah, kill spell. It's fine. We'll play this one. Mina is such a solid unit. Okay, I should have just played this one then. Can't trade into that one. I'll put the Conquest on anyways. Okay. Let's just split this one. I'll just take this. All their BI is one. Okay. It's four. Oh, look at this. Absolutely. Creator cost one less. Nice. Burn? Oh, they do have burn. Okay, so you have to be super careful about playing Mihira.
I'm still good to scrap.
It's plus one. Let's take this one out then. This one will bring something out. That means our Yasuo will always be one. That's super. If you think about it. Okay, we don't have to play Kale this turn. We'll play Kale next turn. I think it's better we focus on defending than anything else.
Happy to do whatever's needed.
Yeah, this turn is more focused on defending than anything else. This one. I don't want to do efficiency block right now. Do too much damage if I do it. Go next. Here's the scout, so it's pretty good. Play this first and then kill. Play Kale. Okay, they're taking that one out, fine by us. They're out of cards at the moment. Scout attack first. Four. Only once. And we can attack this. See, double scout. Scout quick attack is much more valuable. Okay, this is gonna be problematic because this is the strongest. This will get stunned, and then their only one will get stunned. It's not the worst, actually. Seven damage. Not the greatest, but I'm gonna bring Mihira now. I'll take the risk. Yeah, at this moment, I will take the risk. I'll take this.
I have done in your name.
I'm gonna do this then. Should I take this?
This would be hilarious.
I got a Kale as well. This is nutty. You consume that thing? And when you consume the thing, you get a copy of it. Even if it's your own unit. That's absolutely nutty. This is so disgusting. I'm just gonna flood the board and click here. Ah, got stunned. I'll play this one. Play this one.
Just pretend I'm naughty.
Play this one. Actually, I don't know why I played that one. I played this one. Scout at the first 8. That's super nutty. Look at this, like a minion army.
Sure, boss.
There we go. 15. Even then, 15. Yes, that's super nutty. Holy shit, you can capture your own unit and get copy. The reason why Kale was 3 mana is because if you capture a unit, you already get 1 mana less. But the thing is that the thing you capture becomes a created card, and created cards cost 1 less. That's why Kale was 3 mana, which is disgusting. Okay, my cost goes down every turn. Free attack is horrible, in my opinion. I'll take this one then. It reduces cost, goes down, so you just keep it in hand. You can play it for free over turns. Even if you could play it for 2 mana less, it's pretty good. Spell chain on minions is pretty good. Not to mention the fact that we get more copies of minion. So that's even better. Okay. Do we play creator cards? Definitely. Yeah, we do. So I will take the... Yeah. What's on the other side? Okay. I'll take the gear hits. It's decent. Oh, the red path. We're definitely gonna go for the red path.
Yeah, definitely gonna go for the red path.
Yeah, gear hits means you have defenders at the start. Question is, the thing is, the creative cards that we have, we play it a little late though. Mihira is a little dangerous right now against that deck, because that deck is a super aggro deck. So to play units that can block fearsomes and stuff. But we have gear hits there. And these things will be created, so that you have to keep that in mind. Your minions will be created. So let's play minion and let minion die, so you can play the other copies of minion. Other copies of minion, and these guys will grow. Okay, they're not blocking. Super smart, actually. Okay. As we can see, pass, see what they do. You just have to have blockers, that's all. These are all fearsome. Can't even block that one.
Okay, you have to be super careful. Yeah, this is the thing I was talking about.
Creator cast means that we can play this one at least. Let's give it to the yeah. Nice. I'm just gonna pass and see. You play slow, right? They are the aggressive squad, so you don't have to like play too many things at once. You play it after they do. I'm gonna trade into that fearsome here. Should I trade into that fearsome? Yeah. I actually have a decent fearsome blockers across the board. Let's play this one. So that's good for us. We'll just take this one because it's the only fearsome. These are gonna lose fearsome. But we are more concerned about fearsome blocking than anything else right now. The minion just have an extra blocker. This is actually super. Yeah. 3-4-4 HP body. Pass. Yeah, definitely gonna block it. And whatever I can. Sacrifice a minion. 5 HP to face. 5 hit to face. I mean, 5 HP to face. Okay. I'm gonna heal. Hit this. Go next. We get a minion back. Hit this one. And then click kill. Yeah, we are holding on by like super close to death, but how much do is it? 4 shit, man, I can't even block it. Oh, these can't block, so I can't even attack. I think we got them, yeah. Those can't block, so. Okay, we didn't get them though. It's a moment or two. This is the turn I have to survive, yeah. This is the turn I have to survive somehow. I think I can. There's so many fears on blocker now. Go next. Okay, I use a righted. Block. Super. Hit this.
Hit this. Corner, pull this one. There's blood in the
water. Yeah, we'll always get stunned. The strongest of our side will always get stunned. I can't technically attack with her. She won't grow ever. Oh, life's super. Let's attack the scout first. I could have open attack, but still, why take the risk? Okay. So we'll just do this. There's only one blocker here. Yeah. There we go. Ah, man, 13 HP. We are not at all doing well. I shouldn't say well.
It takes a lot of face damage.
Even after making a good deck, even with decent support synergy, we are taking this much damage. Okay, I'll take draw one when you consume.
Already have a bunch of them in our deck. Okay, Trifear might be super difficult to activate. We don't actually have anything in the 5 category.
When you draw, it gets +1/+1. So that's actually much better in my opinion. Do I take a reroll here? Okay, I'll take a reroll here. Chrono Break is pretty hilarious. Fury is disgusting. Our cards grow as it is. We get +1/+1 for every surviving. Yeah, okay. We do a full heal because we have a boss fight. Go, oh, it's karma. Super. Should be fun.
Yeah, should be fun. Yeah. So, we already have our surviving allies at +1/+1. Fury just make it crazier if you're gonna kill it.
Okay, so keep everything because if we start a turn 10. No reason not to. Don't know why it's showing 11. Blitz that, we blitz this. Triple Karma will consume him. Now question is, do they have... Okay, we can't consume him, it's just too... She's just too big. Where there is life, there is hope. Let's play slow then. Oh, they're attacking right here, okay. So, what should I do? Let's play this one, this takes damage anyways. Definitely look like the fuck like this. Problem is that if you have a twin discipline, I'd get like bodied right now, yeah. It's too risky right now. Do this. Unless they use the man up, yeah, unless they use the man up, I'm never gonna commit. Too risky. Obviously take the dragon out.
You get a dragon as well.
Dragon ring, I mean. Ooh, zero mana. I'll take it. I just free body on the board. Free body blocker on the board. Super. Where there's a will, attack with everything because Karma is stunned. Stand firm. Discipline. Exactly, this is the reason why I didn't do it. But right now it's fine. To a certain extent. Because this is gonna get shit, I can rally again. And this one might bring back here. Oh, they get the capture back, right? That's super unlucky. But we can do this. It's focused right here, it's focused. Let's just keep it here. This is glorious. Gotta keep up. Should I can just just do this. Might as well capture it. I don't see a
reason why not. Did this? We each hold a world within. Capture it again. Zero mana, just capture stuff.
And get it again. It's actually nuts. You can do such an infinite combo with the sword. Your lesson begins. And every time you play this, these guys grow. Yeah, Fury is absolutely nutty. The spirit gives to those who listen. I don't know what I just did, but I did it. Do we get Tahm Kench? That's a question. What was the strongest thing that died? I think it was Kench. No, it's not Kench. It burned a lot, actually. Okay, catch. Oh, damn, Poro. Oh, damn, another Poro. I think they can attack. They can attack in the long run, though. Okay. Can't block and elusive, unfortunately. Trace that one, take that one. Go next. Stun the strongest one. I think this should do it. I don't see a reason not to. The double stun, we have triple. Five attackers. Yeah, but they lose their karma. Unless they have another twin discipline. Nope, they lost their karma. I think they have another karma in their hand. Rally would be perfect right now. Pass. I just have to take care of that elusive right there. I should be fine. Armor, second karma. Frostbite. Yeah. You just wait and see what they do. Oh, it's a capture one, right? All of the captures are gonna come back now. No has war sweep or anything. Okay. So we play this one. And give this one here. It becomes elusive. Go next. Pull this elusive one out of the way and you'll be fine. Because they don't have any elusive blocker. We'll just do this. Actually, I'm doing okay with this one. And that should be fine. There's a kill here. Unless they have a concussive bomb, they don't make it. There we go. Super.
A little clutchy in the end.
We didn't get Kale nor... we did get Kench. But yeah, super. Oh, damn, man. That was super close. Yeah, I thought it would be more comfortable than that. But we got them. Okay, so the 1.5 star weekly challenge, the Karma Path done with our 1-2 star Tahm Kench, level 5. Let's see what we get. Okay, A. Champion achievement and power decision time. So we got our support squad scale, Kale having overwhelm for the start is very decent. And of course, Scout. We gave an attachment of Scout, so she's a quick attacker, overwhelm Scout. Pretty disgusting. But she needs time to grow over. Her attack power grows over time. So that's a little clutchy. And Haunted Tomb doesn't work with her. That's a very good, very important information to know. Haunted Tomb doesn't work with her because she's super weak because of the fact that her original stat line is 1. It doesn't matter how much empower attack power she gets. And due to that reason, she will never be summoned from. Not just never, but majority of the case, she will never be summoned by Haunted Tomb. Okay, anyways, let's look at the power. When you summon an ally granted Fury, it is a dragon. The reason why this is good is because Tahm Kench is original power already. One star power is whenever a surviving ally, ally survives damage, they get +1/+1. So them having Fury means if they kill and survive, they get +2/+2, which is pretty disgusting. Because +2/+2 over time, every turn when you attack or defend is pretty nice, crazy actually. Game starts summon two arm gear heads. All the things that we consume or capture, we get a copy of a created card. So whenever we play them, we get that. When we play created cards, gear heads, attack power goes up, as well as the code that we had creates gems, and create gems contribute towards arm gear heads attack power increases as well. Your created cards cost 1 less is pretty disgusting because the things we capture, we can play it for 1 cost less, and they're created so they cost 2 less. So that's why you saw that I played Kale for 3 mana. And this your created cards costing 1 less has good and very good decent synergy with Tahm Kench's deck. When next power is when an ally dies for the first time, summon a Haunted Tomb. Haunted Tomb is pretty good. It's a decent power. It's much better than it looks. So always having a free unit coming onto the board when it dies is pretty good. And if you can actually kill a ally or a champion on purpose, it still will come back. Exception is Kale because her attack power is low. Moving on to the next power, is Stun the Strongest Enemy. It's an absolute disgusting power. It's actually good in almost every deck that you can play. Stalls the game in, which is, and of course, a big unit on the board can never attack because of this power. Game start, draw 2 is a decent power. Higher cards in the starting hand is always appreciated. Moving on to the next power, which is Tahm Kench's 2-star power. Every game starts, you get 1 extra mana, and when you capture a unit, create a copy of it in hand. Create, so it's a created card, costs 1 less. So created cards cost 1 less, and this costs 1 less combined, so the card costs 2 less. That's why you saw I have the dragon being played for 0, because I have the dragon is 2 mana, and it's created, and another discount has happened for the power, and it costs 0 mana because it costs 2 less. Pretty nice. And of course, when an ally survives damage, granted +1/+1, and that's about it. Okay, it's the 2-star MF path, I think. The weekly challenge with our 2-star Thresh. Let's do this. Okay, yeah. So Thresh is 2-star, and level 8 is still super weak. I wouldn't want attachment on him. Wait. Yeah, quick attack. So the challenge is quick attack. Yeah, it's okay. Okay, Frostbite the Strongest is pretty disgusting. Probably one of my favorite power next to Stun the Strongest. Stun the Strongest is actually stronger than this. Okay, wait, we have to talk about the mutators. Okay, all enemies have overwhelm, and they have a Hextech Foundry, I think. Yeah, they have a Hextech Foundry always, and all enemies have overwhelm. Pretty disgusting if you think about it. Could be painful, yeah. You have low HP units to block. Let me have File Fist for a heal. Okay, I'm gonna pass. I'm gonna bank the mana for Vile Fist being open all the time. I'll play this one. I think this is a mistake. I should have played this guy on a defending turn. I did attack with everything. This guy is Vile Fist open now. Nice. I can play this one, set up for this one next turn. Prosper the Stronger is pretty nice. This one? Okay, definitely block. Flip this one. What does he want from me? Go next. Yeah. Okay, let's check how many cards we have in our hand. We might burn stuff. Yeah, we're definitely gonna burn. Okay, so due to that reason, let's split this one first. The breath takes, the waters give. 8. This time it will be fine. And swing at everything so that we can play other stuff on the board. By that I mean Wild Fist. Yeah, they get that one and Wild Fist it, and we'll have it. We have 10. Okay, we don't have 10 cards, so we can just go next. Yeah, we don't have to worry about that. I thought we had board space problem.
Oh, wait.
Oh, Hextech. Oh, this is that one. Hexcore Foundry. That's why. We draw one extra. That's why I'm saying, why am I getting. Yeah. Why am I getting so many cards? It's problematic. I'm gonna. Oh my god, dude. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. Oh, shit, 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 shit. Oh man, we're gonna lose. Let's put a Thresh in the deck. Oh damn, even then we'll lose. This is dangerous. Yeah. Oh damn. 10, 10, 11, yeah. Yeah, we will lose next turn. Oh no, no, oh no, oh no. Yeah, we will lose next turn if we don't attack. I have to attack. Please don't have anything. Oh no, I think we lost. Oh, we lost. Because there's two cards left and yeah, we lost. I don't think we could have done anything even if we wanted to. This is dangerous. This is a dangerous path. Oh, the weirdest way of winning. Losing, I mean. We still have a chance. We still have a chance. Oh my god, Prankster for the win? No, no, we don't want that. Oh no, we lost. Dude, we lost. Damn. No. This is so dumb. I didn't even see it. I realized it super late. Like, wait, how do you win this then? Dude, like, yeah, Thresh is not aggro.
Ugh. Okay.
Did we lose fully? Oh no, we have one revive. Okay, so this is gonna be problematic. We have to rush
and we have to keep how many. Keep in mind how many cards we have in our
deck. But wait, that's problematic. How do we rush them? Okay, yeah, definitely we don't play anything that draws cards. That's super problematic. Yeah. Okay. Change of plans then. We'll play aggro then. That means it's gonna get better as we go through the path. But at the start, it's always a problematic thing. Running out of cards. We're gonna rush against them. And we're definitely not gonna draw stuff. Yeah, if we didn't have the spirit, if we didn't play the spirit leech, we would have much better odds. Okay, dish out the damage. Play the prankster and start doing face damage to blocks.
Hmm? Oh man, I realized it's so late.
Okay, no draws. Fresh is worth at least twice as much. So then we're gonna go for our prankster, right? So we just dip in our prankster. Just dip in our prankster. Okay. Yeah, the game is much easier when you realize what's happening. Even then, it's super close. Damage. Yeah, even then it's super dangerous. Can't draw anything. Oh man. Oh, this is super scary. Please. I'm gonna replace my Thresh. Oh, these heal, dude. Oh, this is so pain, dude. The box. Just put another Thresh in the deck. I do kill them, right? Yeah, I do kill them. Even if they heal, at least I have a better swing next turn without them. I don't even have anything in my deck that will get pulled out, so it's irrelevant. But we actually dish out a lot of damage. Oh, they have that card, right? Man, we're still going to lose. Okay, Prankster is here. They go for Thresh, it's fine, but yeah, 7 damage. I think we made it this time. 3 cards left. I think we made it. Yeah, there we go. The Prankster. Like this, against this one. 2 damage and Avengers next turn. 2 damage. Three cards left and we just kill our unit. And we vengeance our own unit to win. How crazy is that? Yeah, there you go. Oh my god, dude. What a pain. Oh.
Super disgusting.
Yeah, you wouldn't realize how he would lose until it's like you're about to lose. I'll take this. It's pretty nice. Use this card. Support squad. See, anything that's cheap should be pretty good. Nothing expensive. I'll take this one. At least into this is pretty nice, if it, in my opinion. At least into Thresh is pretty good. Shop, item, shop will get priority. My question is, am I gonna run out of cards every game? Or the first game? Because it's normally very typical for you to lose all your cards in the first fight. Because your deck is made of soulless cards. But I don't think it's gonna happen anymore. But even then, let's play a little safe. Huh? Shot one damage. Go next. We definitely want Prankster. Prankster is super damage across the board. Can't play Elise. Let this one. They're not gonna pull anything, yeah. Because they're smart AI. Okay. Okay, Prankster is here. Super. Okay, can't play Prankster. With Prankster will get vulnerable, that's fine. Oh, damn it. Might as well play at least then. I know what lurks in the shadows. Okay. This then. A tribute to the spider god. Attack like this. They're definitely gonna block something. Think they're gonna block something. Okay. This spider will die. Because there's no space. Yeah, we are in space problem as well. I'm not gonna draw any cards. Just too risky at the moment. The Thresh. Oh damn, I didn't even see that. Oh dude, I didn't see that. And play so bad. Super bad. I can't even activate these. Okay, now I can actually somewhat. Prankster. I don't have to do it with that though. Let's challenge it this guy's turn. Okay, let's do this. 5 damage. Yeah, we're doing much better. Go next. Yeah, I don't want to play another Prankster into that. But we definitely want to play a second Prankster on the board. Question is, how do I play it? Stand in a space. Now I'll play the second Prankster. Even if she gets vulnerable, it's fine. They don't have any attackers coming in from their side. Yeah. Okay. I don't know what that attack was, okay, but we'll take it. 10 cards left. Let's draw. It's fine. This to deal more damage. We must all make sacrifices. And that should be fine. Yeah, we'll pull this and swing and finish them off. Yeah, it was only the first game that we struggled that much. Now it's fine. Swing here. And swing. We don't have to swing at everything too. We could use a bite. There we go. Elise for the win, and that excluding that blunder that we did with Thresh. I didn't see that they summoned a rolling sand. I'm going blind. Some of us are okay. So far, so decent. Not even that good. One costless quick attack. Just I think this is the best one. Constantly coming back into my hand. Create a cost one less means it's that dude will also cost one less. Let's see what we can get. Okay, I will take 102. I'm tempted to buy this, but actually I will take it. A Glimpse Beyond for 1 mana is pretty good. Let's see what we can get. Surviving Alex is +1/+1 is okay. Not the greatest, but we'll take it. Dredger, Gold, Smooth Solace. There's 0 point of going to... Okay, I can actually go to Smooth Solace because I will get 100 gold and I can buy a common power.
But I won't
be able to buy anything rare and epic, unfortunately. Okay. Prankster will get priority, so as you're playing 3 mana, we don't need the other 3 mana, so it's a 2 mana, 3 mana, it's pretty good.
On a curve. Yeah, he's also good. I think I'll play Conchologist first. What spell we get? Oh, second prankster. Play that. I think I'll play, yeah, then. Gets traded and comes back to my hand, yeah. Oh, this comes here. Super.
I'll set up our prankster.
Question is, do we set up a prankster this turn or next turn? Wait, it's the Yao one, treasure trove one. Oh, I hate this fight so much. And I'm just gonna play prank, set up prankster. It's not fearsome, so it's fine. He finds minion. Now we play minion into Conchologist. I don't think we ever needed Vile, yeah, Clue Spin. I don't know why it took it. Okay. We don't have a Vile Fist for protection, unfortunately. We'll just play this one. Just go next. I don't want to draw anything, obviously. Prankster. Just go next. We can't even play Treasure Trove if we want to. We don't have space in our hand to play it. Fine, we play this. I think I will attack with it. Nah, can't attack. Unfortunately, let's take that one out. Yeah, might as well help the toss thing. I need these guys to block that, those things. Not that they will block it efficiently, because those are overwhelm, but still. Nevertheless, I need to block 17 cards. To keep the number of cards in my deck pretty. I have to be cautious of how many cards in my deck. Can start burning now, yeah. Back. Constantly going for my pranksters, dude. I think I'm protecting my prankster is way more important than protect killing that one. I think pranksters constant damage across the board. Are they going deep yet? Nope. They have a treasure trove, but you don't have a space for treasure trove as well. Yeah, this one actually contradicts the treasure trove thing. Not counter makes the entire thing counterproductive. Is that this one? What is this? 2 damage taken, I'll take it. At the moment, I need the discard. Let us take a peek at life beneath the wave. Devour. Okay. I'm okay with this. I don't want to draw, obviously. Oh. 2x6, quite far away, if you think about it. I'll just do this. You know what a hollowed. Actually pretty super close, yeah, 4x6. There we go. You're dishing out good damage across the board.
Search levels up,
but we don't get any value yet.
Next attacking turn, we'll get.
But questions, I don't see myself doing damage to face. Like, how? How many cards do I have? 13. Decent. 13 means we have 6 turns. Unless we draw. I think I'm vengeance that one. Nah, I can't draw. To let it go. This piece will be transformative. I'm actually okay with this trade. Oh, they went deep. Makes sense. Persistence is key. Yeah, it's fine. I have to block it. 13. Oh, damn. 11 damage. Dude. Yeah. die. Followed two. A definitive play stuff. Burn. I'll feast. It'll close. Let's play slow. Putting back in my deck. Is that good or bad? Yeah, the only thing we would have gotten is like a lease, so it's not actually the worst. I think at this point I just treasure trove, right? Don't get any value out of anything anyways. You might get something crazy. And not that crazy. Okay, give an I give a unit, I take double damage, and if I would die. It's useful if I overall. This will kill us if we play it. So that's funny. Unfortunately, I have to swing. I actually have to risk it. Yeah, I have to play her. As bad as she might be, I have to play her. Who is pulling it? Oh, I could have killed it. Okay, now that she's blocking like that. Yeah, it's gonna be super close. Oh man, okay. Do this then. And heal a bit before you die. She's gonna kill three units on the board. But we're dying to that one though. We're dying to almost everything, actually.
Unless we get, yeah, or unless we get, yeah. Oh, so close. Oh, I think we got them.
Man, we got them by a like skin of our teeth. We'll just kill this one. How many cards do we have left? We have enough. Yeah, and that should do it. Oh my god, dude. That was super close. Holy shit. Survived 2 HP. Yeah, super slow, in my opinion. Okay, I can't even take in. I can't even buy anything, by the way. So there's no point going to the shop because I'm gonna go get a full heal. So might as well go to the dredger. Cost plus one extra. Skill 7 for 5 free. I'll take it. At the moment, I need heal more than anything. We do a full heal, obviously. 2 HP, no revive. Yeah, we lost our power along the way, but there's no way I'm gonna fight Tahm Kench with 2 HP, considering the fact that they all have overwhelm. I think I just... Okay, definitely vengeance. Okay, I think I need to call one of the big guns for this pet. This pet doesn't seem normal. It's way more difficult for a 2-star pet, obviously. Thresh just sucks as 2-star. Okay, so they're gonna attack with 3, so we can't technically do anything about that. Might as well. Yeah, might as well just take the hit. Oh, she has 5 HP. That's nice. If we play Prankster, actually makes no difference. But I think open attacking is the best way to do it. We get extra body, we dish out damage. And we could prepare afterward. Yeah. Now we can hit this one. Oh man, that was a mistake. That was a super mistake. I should have kept the vengeance open for Kench. Wait, they can't play. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, they can't eat, I mean. Just split this one. This is fine. It's a bit crazy. Vengeance is open, so we have to vengeance when they do something. So we can actually play this. It's fine by us. This will give us a body. Yeah, see how much haunted two will make a difference in the long run. I mean,
I'm sure there's something for my
just put this.
We could use the bite.
You really shot damage as much as you can. Okay. That means they're gonna not consume this turn.
A feast awaits.
Did this one? Play Thresh. Yeah, we have Vengeance open for the consume. This is a very good face off. Super face off, actually, in my opinion. Ah, the new champ is here.
I will see about that, Pablo.
I want to get remote draws. Draw doesn't help me at all. But they are attacking. It wouldn't logically make sense for us to attack in that moment. They're taking a lot of cards from 13 cards left. 3 damage to face is fine, I guess. The new champ. Okay. It's 5x6, so we can technically level him up super easily. We can just play this. This will level him up and swing and level Thresh up. We get Elise. And I think Elise also summons something right during the attack. I'll fight this one.
Lock the doors.
Just do this. It summons Elise. I think Elise also summons something. Huh. Nice. Super.
What's your wager?
Super. It's actually pretty good. Kill across the entire world. Play our Conchologist. Unit, you recall a unit with 3 or less attack power. You're funny, I'll take it. I'll just do this. Keep this one under check. And have another Thresh in the deck. In case we're running out of cards, which technically we are in a weird manner. It's fine. It's fine. We just want to trade our units into them. The Thresh. Man. We are moving into dangerous territories. This is what we were saving our vengeance for. A reactive play against them. Does this hit anyone? Only one. Nah, we just go next, it's fine. Yeah, we're actually super close. 8 cards left. So it is super weak. That's what the thing is, that this entire path is going to kill you, Mil. It's not just the first fight, all of the fights. So the fun thing about here is the fact that even if they defend, we are getting damage because of the Prankster. And funnily enough, the second Prankster is in the end of the deck. Unfortunately. Oh, they took our Prankster, that's fine. And this is a boss fight, so we actually get HP back, so not too worried. I'm gonna problem is vengeance. You don't want to vengeance it now, because if you vengeance it, they might just play another Tahm Kench. So might as well don't kill it at the moment. I'll just play another Conchologist just and get some cards. Oh, this is actually hilarious.
Astounding curiosities lie ahead.
I'm just gonna slowly kill them. Without drawing cards, of course. Five damage. Question is, how do I do the 5 damage now? How do I do the 5 damage? Six cards left. 5 cards left.
So what's in store for me?
I need time for commute, Tahm. This you know.
Well, or to come a day where I have to win through, yeah, holy so shit, dude. You, the guts, hey, big fella? Or to win through Prankster, dude.
I was conjecturing your arrival.
You know me, Tahm. I follow the blood.
One more turn. We have to lose next turn anyways. I think that should do it. There's no point attacking with the I think this attack should do it. Even if they defend, they lose, yeah. Okay. Are my cards still not dying? Oh, the surviving allies. Dude, I think we're dead. Yeah, we died. There's nothing we can do. They healed as well, dude. We need our units to die, and there's no way to do it. They grew too much, so it's counterproductive. Yeah, we lost. Two draws here, and we have no way to answer that.
Lock the doors.
I think we survive with one more extra thing.
Close enough.
Let's do this. We just have to do it so that we can shuffle another card in the deck. So we survive one turn. Yeah, we need Crumble to break that thing. I think I realized that too late now though.
So, Mabes, how long have I got left?
Oh, my little please, Rick. Don't worry about such
things. I actually want my Yeru to die. So see what run of cards, yeah. Have to attack like this, for sure. Just have to attack like this. Four damage. Question is it enough? I think that should do it. There we go. My god, dude! Holy shit, look at no cards in my hand. This is such a pain. Oh my god. I'm looking for Crumble. I need things to break landmark. Heal is less important. I'll take Elise in my hand. I'm looking for things that break, yeah. Landmarks. Purple sense is pretty disgusting, I'll take it. Healer, item, power will get priority. Okay, yeah. So we're looking for stuff that will directly kill landmark. So we can just hex, blow up the hex core foundry. I actually didn't understand that this was this one. I thought this was that one that gives you mana back. Super pain, dude. And you definitely don't want to have draw. Never play any draw. Okay. Lucky. Don't call it this thing. Frostbite the strongest.
Where's my axe?
What's the killing? Yeah. It's on to your sleep and this for me. Prankster will give it. Prankster won us the game there. Like from start to finish. So we immediately attack, they show the damage, they have no blockers on their side. Dude, look at the HP, dude, 40. They're crazy. I'm barely surviving as it is. At this point, I think you should just go for Thresh, right? I need a fearsome blocker for that one. Oh, I don't have to worry about that one then.
There's no way to
this should be fine.
Okay, they have a lot of attack coming in. Super firepower coming in. I have to take the trades. As bad as it may seem. Come, stay a while. Even then, we are taking this much damage. I normally wouldn't take the block with the prankster, but I have to, or else I take too much damage. Who's coming to the thing? Five, six. Let this one. Five. I'm not gonna draw, so might as well just drain. Yeah, might as well drain them. And the double L at least is funny is because we have a prankster. If they kill the thing, if they kill the spiders, that's good for us. So we have Sia here, six here. Yeah. Okay. Prankster. Prankster is our only win condition, as weird as it may seem. And Thresh's job is done. She pulled a unit onto the board. Elise levels up. Wait, Elise isn't a spider? Yeah, she is. For a second, I thought that she's not a spider herself. Oh, what is that? Stun all damage units. This dude is getting the hammer for sure.
It's playtime.
Thresh. Next.
These fingers are super growing on the one.
Lemon, level up at least is doing wonders for us. Yeah, level up at least is getting us. Cards. I don't want to risk it, yeah. Why risk it? Just play slow. Give another vengeance against that one. Yeah, we don't have to worry, yeah. They will always get frostbitten. Am I missing something? Is there a way to block, kill the landmark? Don't think so. Kill. Damage. One damage short. Did 9 damage though. If you have 3 Elises on the board. Yeah, I think this should do it. I don't think we even have that many of this in the deck. I don't think Thresh is gonna pull anything from the deck. For the joke of it, let's see. Far left, right. Is there anything in the deck? I don't think so. Oh, they have another release. Okay. There we go. We got him. Damn, man!
Holy shit, dude.
This path is not at all a 2-star. It feels like it's 3.5-star or some shit. After struggling so much, the best person to play this path is Talia, without a doubt. They have direct landmark break on their side again. So this is bad. This is fine. Don't take draw. Draws suck here. Unless you can break the Hextric Foundry. Okay. Random keywords. I'll take random keywords. Random keywords can win you games. One elusive one across the board and it'll be fine. Stun the strongest in UK. So we already have the Frostbite the strongest. The stun the strongest and Frostbite the strongest is counterproductive. It hits the same target for some weird reason. Grow my power to match my health. Thresh will get a lot of power. Is there anything on the other side?
There's another shop on the other side. If I buy anything right now, I will have 165. I think I will have enough, right? Might as well try it. Yeah. Champion attachment. Okay. You know what? I'm just going to go for the champion attachment set. The reason why I'm going for champion attachment set is because I need the gold to do a full heal here. If I go buy this power, I will not have enough to get a full heal. So I'm just going to go this side. Yeah. I'm just going to go for the attachment, champion attachment, because it's free and get a full heal and face off against the boss. What one is this? Jaull Hunter? I don't remember the Jaull Hunter one. Okay. You're being off the game for a while if we get a lot of things. Yeah, the feral senses. Presence is discussing the senses we can get. I can look for the prankster. Skip. We're just looking for a prankster. Or at least. Yeah, at least early game release is super. And being able, grow my attack to match my health. And it says permanent, by the way. It doesn't go down. It stays the same, yeah. You're still looking for, Skip, yeah. As long as you don't get that one, you skip. Okay, weak attack. It will take our time, we don't have to rush. Play this one. Here's a big one. Yeah, see how much value you're losing without playing the prankster on the board. This is fine. Yeah, see we dished out a lot of damage to face if we had prankster. Actually not that much, yeah, 2 damage. Well, these 2, 3, 4, this goes a long way in the end. Prankster. I can't remember which fight is this. What if we have a good board on the board? Good board on the board, good.
Squad on the board.
Dude, where is my prankster, dude? Imagine how many predicts we got and still didn't get what we wanted. It's fine. We are okay with losing cards at the moment. Now at this point, I think I'm gonna draw. Yeah, I normally don't want to draw, but I take it back. I need the draw. Prankster, and at this point, even if you get prankster, it won't help because you're gonna burn cards. We could
use the bite. Yeah, you're gonna burn cards too much.
Even if you don't get prankster, you should at least get elusive or something. Like, yeah, the power, I mean. Okay, we are dishing out decent damage. For prankster, or prankster, Thresh.
Oh, how many cards do we have? 9. So Thresh is safe. The second one dies. And even Thresh doesn't. Yeah, never mind. Thresh also dies.
Now we'll get prankster. Okay. Where is my prankster? Let's take it out. Draw. Oh my god, you know your luck is bad when you can't even predict the one card that you need. Yeah, thank god for that.
Oh damn, man. This was super scary. Yeah, it was super scary.
No. I think this is the right way for the champion attachment. Take it. Let's check how much gold they get. Okay, from a copy of myself is pretty good. But I get more cards in my hand, it's gonna get super lucky. This is draw, then I don't want draw. I think I'll take this one. Over time, this goes to 0. I'll take it. How much gold do I get? Okay, so we wouldn't be able to afford it. See, we were 5 gold short of getting an epic part there. Free attack, at least. If I'm a copy of Thresh. I think if I'm a copy of Thresh, it's much better. A million times better, in my opinion. You have more craziness at the start. Okay, definitely a full heal and face off against MF. Oh damn, this would be pain. Yeah, we were 5 gold short for buying that power, and we wouldn't be able to buy it, get a full heal if we did get that power. So yeah, this is the right decision to go for the attachment. You have Elise coming in always, so not too worried about that. Okay, they double attack, right? When I force attack, yeah, so they double attack. When I say double attack, I mean the MF passive is activated all the time. It's not during only MF attack. My god, dude, where have you been? My prankster was on a vacation last game. MF is 5-5, okay. I'll take it. Yeah, they can't technically attack because she has tough. She gets traded there. I'll take this one because this thing's cost goes down over turn, so I'll play it for free eventually. Yeah, this one. Some pranksters. I have to flood the port, right? Somewhat. Get this one. Make sure prankster is in the hand. Okay. Yeah, we stabilized the board, which is good. Which is the one thing that I wanted to do. Which we are struggling to do, actually. It's fine. Minion comes back, so we're not too worried. Every bit of damage makes a difference. That's why prankster is so good. So he's an infernal copy, so we don't want to summon him this turn. We're gonna summon him next turn. I'm just gonna play this to have a blocker. That's it. No special reason. Dies. Okay, we can't actually play. We need board space. Fine. Play another prankster. What they were thinking. Super. Two prank turns means double the fun. Oh, at least it's 8-8, dude. Yeah, without even dishing out damage, like, the face, we are killing them through prankster. Yeah, power. This one. Skill to summon. Oh, it, oh my god, because the faded dude. We don't want to kill Elise. We don't want to kill MF with this one because they're gonna summon another one. That's why you play. That's why we're playing it slow. We're letting them do things. 20, it's fine. Yeah, because we're chipping away their phase damage. We're chipping away phase damage as it is. Let's just play it slow and keep on doing this. This thing are we doing? Even if they block, they're taking damage. 4 damage. Slowly getting them out.
Keep firing till they're dead on the ground. My kind of plan.
Man, if he had raiding party. Thresh is fine. Go next. Can't play anything, weirdly. Yeah, definitely don't want to kill MF. See, this thing is now 0. Over 5 turns, but still. 18 cards in our hand, so we're not worried about dying to mill. Which is the most important one. And this is a Thresh will die, by the way. Attack with everything. This time we're gonna have to attack with this one as well. The girl has impact on her. Oh, to match my, yeah. Oh, I could have attacked with her always then.
dude. Anyways, we got him. We got him.
I forgot about the match. I don't take that power. Match my attack power.
Grow my attack power to match my health.
It's pretty good then.
Okay, man, this was super painful. Way more painful than I thought it would be. 2-star Emepath. The weekly chance done with our 2-star Thresh. Let's see what we get. Okay, okay, champion achievement power discussion time. So the support squad we got was Elise. She, her having giant spell giving two extra HP. So she's a 2 mana, 2/5. Then gave her a far sight alteration. So she will be always be in my hand at the game start, which is actually pretty good because she's an early game champion. And having him on the board means we can play her on turn one. Moving on to the powers, grow my power to match my health. This is a very good power. I'm not very good used to it. Used to using this power that much, that's why I was making a lot of mistakes. But yeah, Elise and Prankster work pretty well with it, as well as Thresh. Moving on to the next power, which whenever you summon an ally, grant a random keyword. Oh, this is good. Sometimes you get a random keyword that can win you a game, lifesteal or elusive, so having that probability is always appreciated. Moving on to the next one, which is Feral Senses. Round start, create a fleeting feral presence in hand. You can always predict something. So you can always predict a strategy by picking whatever card you want. Sometimes you need a specific card, sometimes you need another specific card. This helps you build up that sequence of drawing. Pretty nice. When an ally survives damage, granted +1/+1, it's okay. Not the greatest. Majority of them don't survive, like Elise, Thresh, and Prankster being an exception, but majority of them do die. When an ally dies for the first time, summon a hunter team, always appreciate it. Amazing power. It's better than it looks, so always take it. I always take it. Round starts, frost by the strongest enemy, a pretty disgusting power. This power is second next to stun the strongest enemy in terms of stalling, so this is pretty good. This is Thresh's 2-star power. Every game starts, you get 1 extra mana, and Thresh costs 1 less for each ally you have slain this game. And of course, this is Thresh's 1-star power. Round start, for each ally that died last round, get a random ally +1/+1. And that's about it. Okay, so this is a 3.5-star weekly challenge, the Draven Path with our 3-star Yasuo. Yeah, I'm calling one of the big guns for this path, because this path is absolutely not yet ready. Mastery, I got bodied. Okay, so let's look at the power. That's so you understand what I said. Okay, so each enemy has 10 extra HP, 1 extra mana, and 1 extra card in their hand. This is legendary power in their arsenal. Each round, the first time the foe summons a unit, granted +4, granted permanent +4, and overrun. And of course, each round, kill all units except each player's strongest enemy. Absolutely disgusting path. I don't think this is gonna be easy for a majority of the 2-star champions, so yeah, might as well just try it with one of my big guns. That's why I'm pulling out one of the big guns. Okay, so anything of 2 mana. Okay, we have Fey Blade Twirler, and we have attack every turn, and we're slow. The slow and steady is not good because you don't have any slow spells, so I'll take this one. Free unit on the board immediately. That means that we don't have to play anything with 2 mana on the first turn. You get bank 2 mana on the person. I mean, yeah. So legendary power in their arsenal, and this fight has always been the most toughest, one of the most problematic fight at the start of Draven's path. Noxcray Arena fight. Okay, so we'll keep our, yeah. I'm actually gonna keep my, yeah, Will of Ionia. If they play anything big, I'm just gonna counter with it. So we get our Twirler. And immediately they have that one. If I put a barrier, they won't attack. Yeah, true. If I put a barrier, but the only strongest one survives. So if I put barrier, this one dies. So I take the 7 damage here. The reason why I can't play anything is because the strongest one survives. Is it my strongest player or both players' strongest player? Each round kill all units except each player's strongest, so there's only one. So that's hilarious. That means we don't have to play anything other than this one. Okay, we actually have to play something other than that one. I'll do this. Actually, I can do this. It grows, so the thing gets cancelled. Now, this is the strongest one, and everything else will die. That means that we don't ever have to worry about anything, because everything else will always die. Yeah, everything else will always die. We three will have blood. Head right or run. Just done. Here's our chance. They will lose the unit, because only one unit survives. It gets done, and we instead, like, yeah, this is the best person for this dude. Yasuo squad is the best one to fight this path. Okay, even then it's painful. Just to fight each other, right? Okay, weakest one. This one.
Oh, it doesn't happen. Okay, so this will die and then this will react. Yeah, this is what I get annoyed by. The interaction is super weird. Just a lost our win condition. It's fine.
Oh, yeah, still on our side.
That's too much damage, dude.
Reporting in.
Quietly. Can't attack with the barrier on the board. Oh, they're attacking. Fine. Let's go next. You don't want to play anything. There's only one unit survives. Oh. And it's happening non-stop.
Yeah, this one is actually pretty disgusting. You see, even if with a good squad and high level, they're struggling this much.
Pass and see what they do. This is gonna get stunned, so not too worried. And they have to play another unit.
Nothing can stop me.
I'm gonna pass and see what they do. Great. There we go.
No one is promised.
Oh damn,
tomorrow.
That was super painful.
Yeah, Yasuo was built for this path. Absolute monster, dude. And you can only do this combo only once. For not next point onwards, you can't do the combo. Yeah,
I think this is Yasuo's the best path for Yasuo to shine.
Yeah, super. Even then, we took so much damage. It's like 8 damage to face. The capture is hilarious. Printing copy of herself. I'll take 1 mana. 1 mana addition is good. Who should I pick? Releasing is hilarious. I'll take another reroll. Hecarim. Man, if I had free attack Hecarim, I'll take Hecarim. Hecarim's cost goes down, so eventually he'll become zero. Thrashing, yeah. Heal, thrash. The force ply plus R have fearsome. Okay, I definitely want to go here instead of here because these are small units. I have more problematic thing to deal with. Bigger units that are small than this one that are big, right? The five attack powers have fearsome makes no difference. But the small units having overwhelm and 4 plus attack power is problematic.
Throw it, Throne. Throne.
I'm playing Octopat too much. Yone. They're attacking. Have a block. Yeah. Okay, that's fearsome. Oh, damn, dude. It's super painful. Let's get stunned. I disrupt the thing.
For the hand.
Only one survives, so not too worried. Yeah. Only the first one is problematic because it's Rock Nox Kree Arena. The interaction happens even after the block. Ooh, shit. Oh, yeah. That's a lot of damage. You 10 damage. That's fine. We'll take it for the time being. Play anything because it dies. I want to dish out damage at the moment.
Only the finest serve.
Everyone's a garden.
Okay. Dish out damage. And get rid of the card. Yeah, the fact that the strongest one will stay alive and we have stun against the strongest, we should be fine. It's always the thing is that we have to always deal with one extra unit against them. That's all.
They picked the wrong row. Line up.
Interesting.
Okay, ready.
Looking for this.
Nah, I shouldn't play this one. This dies now. Oh, I got him here. I'll see what they do. Okay, rally with what? rally with that. Just kill them.
No one is promised tomorrow. Is a leap's only purpose.
It's disgusting because every round the strongest will get killed by Yasuo. That's the fun part. The strongest will always get killed by Yasuo.
Nothing can stop me.
I do all right.
Four stunts. Let's go next.
Who's ready to wreck? Ooh, that gotta sting.
Yeah, do always try. I have to play Hikaram now. Hikaram will die, but at least we dish out the damage. There we go. Super.
This will be fun for me.
This is the reason why I didn't attack, by the way, because Yasuo would have gotten stunned.
Damn it.
Yasuo is the only one survives, the rest of them die fine by us. We got a pretty good thing out of the way. Yeah, did you see the spell that you use? Imagine they are attacking with overwhelming unit fearsome and then they stun you.
Victory at any cost!
Wait. Super. Yeah, if you're struggling in this path, Yasuo is the answer. Problem is, it's 3-star Yasuo, not 2-star Yasuo. 2-star Yasuo doesn't stun every turn. It stuns only attacking turn. 3-star Yasuo stuns every turn. So yeah, it might not see. Oh my god, dude. Crazy. Might as well heal up. Get stunned, get auto killed. We need aura in our spot. I can stun these people for days. I can stun these people for days.
No cure.
Yes, so. Okay, this time I'm gonna develop, man. The same mistake twice, I'm not gonna do it again. Super.
My siblings.
I'll write my own story. New recruit reporting.
Super cute.
Something
so that even they with the stun I have enough damage. Oh my god, I was struggling so much with Mastery. Holy shit. Yeah, but Yasuo makes it. Even he's not making it easy. It's a 15 damage to face, dude. Healed. Empress. Ugh. It's much better. Next one gets plus 2 plus 3. Okay, heal and heal. Why two heals? Okay. This one. So Marauder. Problematic. Laurentia. Create a fleeting single combat in all players' hand. More problematic if you think about it. Yeah. I'm gonna go for Marauder fight. Heal for 8, go next. Okay, we have a shop and a jump management. Yeah, a couple of fights will be pretty disgusting with this these powers on their side. Not gonna lie. Fine. You have a Hikaram on our side. So it's you. Man, if you don't get it out, Yasuo is also gonna be super problematic. 6. When you summon these, they're gonna come back again.
Let's have some fun.
Damn. It's a barrier right here. It's actually clutch right now, dude. I don't wanna take any face damage unnecessarily. Play Citria? Oop. Is it there?
I'm actually here.
Okay. Second Citria? Actually, it doesn't even matter if you play second Citria. Because you have four, yeah, you have four dragon, yeah, shark chariots coming on in the board as it is, yeah. Super. Oh, they come and heal you. Super. The board gets killed, right? There's no point of playing another one.
None stronger. She's on. None more feared. Tear them apart.
At least you're blocking that one. Thank God you block stun the when they were attacking. It was super problematic.
There we go, our Hecarim.
I can't even level up. Unless they kill it. Nope.
There we go. And the Shark Chariots will actually heal.
Yep. The Shark Chariots will heal when they come out. They heal you for 4.
That's super. Super crazy if you think about it. I didn't actually plan it to be like that, but it worked pretty well. I'll take it. We took a bit damage and we healed for a bit as well.
Super heal.
I'll take it. Champion enrichment. Shop shop will get priority. All allies have over. Probably one of the power that I was looking for. Ooh, what is this? What is this? Infinite hate.
Against Teemo, okay. I don't need to heal. Okay, I mean, he can heal you. Basic heal for 5.
Oh, Swain. Should be fun.
Show them their place. Yeah, Swain should be fun.
Ooh, damn. Overwhelm on Swain. You do have stun ready at least against him. Okay. Spectre Rider is something I like. I'm gonna throw these away. I'm just gonna keep that one. Because we summon something for 2 mana for free, right? We can get a Fade, yeah, or that one as well.
Our attacking turn. Oh, we'll play this one.
Back for 6.
Okay.
So they take less damage. Makes sense. We don't have to play anything unless we have to play something. I'm gonna bank my Malincon next.
New recruit reporting in.
Vision to see what others can.
Got this. Remember, we have Shark Chariots coming in as well. When I say Shark Chariots, I only mean one.
Justify yourself.
Learn from that. Pretty nice. Super go next. I have a recall. That's why I'm playing it so casually. And Sun the Strongest is also always there.
The young fight for glory. I fought for legacy.
We no longer merely fight wars. We declare
true power requires restraint. I think stunning is the best option right now.
I have my orders.
Block it, obviously. Everything else will die, only Swain will survive. But we are getting wider with the Informal Squad. Informal attack, I mean. This is 6-4. Yeah, we reason not to. Okay.
After the battle for Raven's Feast.
Even Swain level up makes no difference, they will never be able to attack.
How long? While their cities crumble.
And full swing. Super. Now, super. She's the only one that survives. Get stunned. Can't really do anything about that.
I stand for Noxus.
I'll just do this. Take it out.
Maybe I do have a future. I go where the road takes me.
I was actually thinking that what would happen if they have another one. That's fine. Stun gets killed. Heck of him. Why not?
Super.
Absolute army. She's pretty good. 26 damage. These will die. Nice. So
Hecarim is a beast.
Yeah, Hecarim Yasuo is fun. At least this path. The only reason I took Hecarim is because I know that only value Hecarim gets is when he attacks. Scout, double attack. I will take that's actually even more hilarious. I'll take Scout Hecarim attack. If you do it twice. Holy shit.
Must by the strongest.
Okay, stun the strongest is already there. Counterproductive, so definitely don't want that one. Look for something else. Your critic cost one less, not the greatest. When you summon a one cost, we don't have one cost. Ah! Citrias are one cost. I'll take it.
Dude, that's crazy.
1 mana, 3 mana, 1 mana, 3/3 Citria. Okay. Gold item. We have a lot of gold, so we go for item. Oh damn, is this the Yeti fight? Is this the Yeti fight? I wanna read it. If this the Yeti fight. When the first Yetis die, create an enrage Yeti in the top three cards of the first deck and grant Yetis everywhere +1/+1. It is the Yeti fight
from the Thresh path. Holy shit, this is a monster fight.
This is way more difficult than it looks. It's gonna give you the impression that it's super easy, but my god, it's difficult. If it's exactly the same way, if the two mana Yetis have Informer on them. Nah, it's not.
The two mana ones and Informer on them is super painful. Okay, is there attacking turn? We'll pass and see what to do. We played slow, we don't have to do anything. So.
Okay, we attack, we shot damage. We don't have to play this, we're not low on HP. But they have super high HP at the moment. Go next. Yeah, the fact that it's only one will survive makes no difference to us. They will never flood the board, which was the Yeti's biggest power. This is the biggest Yeti's biggest power. I just stun this one.
I should have just done this. I should have used this one because now my unit dies.
I can play my Frostbite is irrelevant. I'm just gonna attack. Scout attack. Summon two Infernal. Scout attack again. The next Hecarim will actually level up.
Welcome to the tipsy hour.
Okay. So Hecarim's job is done.
Let's talk about your town.
My question is, does a Frostbite make it the strongest or the weakest? That's a good question. Frostbite makes it the weakest. Okay. Stun.
Elephant. Actually, I can do this.
Kill both of them.
I follow only one.
And prepare a big hit next turn.
Follow the wind. Watch your back.
Now, yeah, we'll always be the strongest.
Hecarim, 2 mana. So what we do is we play this first. See what they do. If I play Hecarim, they might do something. They might frostbite it, right? Yeah, exactly. Due to that reason. We have another Yasuo in the hand, so no worries. We play this one. Okay. Hecarim attacks. He doesn't level up, does he? Nope. He's 1 mana short. Super unlucky. Okay. So I'm just gonna pass, because if I play anything, Yasuo is the one that dies. That's something that I didn't want to do.
Super, you guys here.
Okay. Same deal as before. Block. These two die, and they don't have cards to defend next turn. Because he has zero attack power, he doesn't strike with anything. So go next. Strongest one is this one. This one is survives, and now I can attack with the Hecarim.
I do all right.
Super. Attack with Hecarim.
And she levels up.
Super. If we had Sharks, you know, we don't have Shark Chariots on our side. Now look at this. Citria. 1 mana 4/4. 1 mana 4/4. 1 mana 4/4. 1 mana 4/4. Super.
the stack. Super. All of them will die, but it's fine. Stun gets killed. Yeah, so the chain will go on. This combo will happen non-stop, and they don't have cards to defend now. This auto dies.
And we just swing and finish them off. Super.
Yeah, if it was anyone other than Yasuo stunning, holy shit, we would be in a horrible spot. Yeah, super.
Yeah, this is nice path. Niceness. Nice path, yeah.
I'm gonna draw a rally. Super.
Informal. Informal is hilarious. Nah, it's not. I think I will. Nah, I don't want this guy to cost more. This guy's doing a lot as it is. I'll take Informal, I guess.
Go to the shop. Upper fixer. Slash shop. Let's check. Yeah, there's a champion enrichment spell. Obviously, champion enrichment will get priority. I'll take a reroll. Upper fixer. Weakest one, I don't want. Definitely, you're gonna mess up the thing if you do it. Informal copy, don't really want. One over to the weakest one, I'll take it.
The weakest one getting plus 3 means that it will change whoever's the strongest. And Yasuo might get killed.
So this is much better. We go for the champion enrichment, obviously.
Okay. Want this, don't want this. Actually, keep one of this, just in case we don't get our stun. Okay, let me see here. Pretty good. So that he gets discount every turn. Victory requires a sharp blade. Is that this one? When the force on that strike. When the one of force units strike for 5+, I grant it +2/+2. Face me. That makes sense. The dual dragon with that one. Yeah, dish out damage.
Okay. Interesting.
Sharpen the blade, secure the kill. Shh, quietly.
There's barriers, so that's pretty good. No, they have to attack. They have to attack wider than us. Because they are going wider than us. The dark beckons. Yeah, makes sense. Oh damn, we're doing so much damage, dude. Yeah, that's because we didn't get Yasuo. That's what we're talking about. It looks nice on all because you're getting Yasuo. Without Yasuo, it's gonna be super problematic. Not this turn though.
Let's make this a night to remember.
The crowd will tremble. Let's see if they're willing to actually take 8 damage to face.
Someone on top of the deck is getting +12/+12. They are super smart. Someone on top of the deck is getting +12/+12.
Who is it? The dude got +12/+12. Oh, wait, +3/+3. Ugh.
Let me just play this from the players, you know.
Okay. Fine. Dude, we took too much damage. It's fine, we're actually getting a full heal at least for this shark. Oh my god, the shark is the strongest. I didn't see it. I saw it too late. Get this one. For rally. Super.
I follow only one path.
The Yasuo ace.
My own. Is a leaf's only purpose.
Remember me. Super.
We should happen at the start. I don't have to play anything. Swinkin finishes it off. There we go. I could play Hecarim, but no need. I just want to get out of this nightmare. Super paid. Yeah, it's been a while since I'd struggled this much in a weekly challenge. Okay. Actually, I didn't like any of them. I just might as well take this one. Champion attachment. Okay. More stats to. Yeah, Yasuo. We'll come here and get a full heal because we have too much gold lying around.
Yeah, we actually take too much damage.
Anyways, this is the 3.5 star weekly challenge, the Draven Path, with our 3 star Yasuo. Welcome. Let's do this. Yeah. This is where it all ends. This is fine. Spectre Rider is okay.
It's plus six.
Get attacking. Oh, we got shark. Super.
Oh, it is a great day for a
normally, I get a yeah on our side. I shouldn't have used it. I'm just burned mana for nothing. You have to play a little carefully here.
A single empire ruled by the true king.
Block it like this. So when they attack with that one, I gotta just trade with Citria. I have to attack or they would double attack with Draven. They're attacking with that one. Interesting.
I'll take it, it's fine. Yes, so it's 2.5.
Problematic. Super problematic to be exact. They're attacking twice. You have to be super careful about that. Yeah, they're attacking twice. So you have to be super careful about that. Okay, now they gave up. Okay, fine. They never mind. They gave up the thing.
Oh, it's on.
What? That's fine.
It doesn't matter. Whichever I would have blocked, they would have axed that one. So it makes no difference which one you would have blocked.
I definitely don't want to block the Draven because they get a free Draven next turn.
Every turn, I mean.
All of them dies. Oh, this is pretty disgusting. All of their one die and Draven comes back again. So they will always have two units and you will always have one. Five. Pass. What did
you? Nothing can stop me. I have come for the unforgiven.
Pretty sure our damage against the person's face. And level up here as well.
Face me.
Yeah,
playing this path with anyone, this fight with anyone else other than the person who doesn't have strong, the strongest would be absolutely broken.
Like, painful for me.
It's a 7 indeed.
A single empire ruled by the true king.
Just blow up the board, then they have nothing to do.
I will follow this path until the end.
Return home, Yasuo.
Shit, they do have a blocker, attacker. Just do this.
Kills it.
Kills that one next round. And we have a Hecarim hit coming in. Draven's arrows. Yeah, okay, this is not actually as simple as I thought it would be.
It could have been a 3x7.
Yeah, now he actually it's pretty good because we played this one. Drag with that one and get one strike in. And we get next strike, we heal a little up. And he has overwhelm as well.
How many? 4, 5. Okay, we can
put one more on the board. Yeah, put one more on the board.
Look at this. Super. Nice. And he will buff everyone. And everybody has overwhelm. Super. Great way to finish the game. Yeah. Hecarim coming in clutch. And the discounted Hecarim is even better. Super, super. Okay. So yeah, the 3.5 star weekly challenge, the Draven Path done with our 3 star Yasuo, calling in all the big guns to finish it off because I was struggling with the mastery a lot. Okay, so let's see what we get. Okay. Champion achievement power decision time. So the two rare attachment I have on my Yasuo from the start is Caulfield's Warhammer, giving him +2/+1. And of course, then I get another attachment is Tempest Blade. When I'm leveled up, stun all the enemies. Basically, when he's on the board or when you play him on the loop. After leveled up, he stuns everything on the board, and it's Yasuo, so he strikes for everything for his attack power. So he's basically a board wipe by himself if you play it right. And yeah, that's the strategy. And of course, a phage so that his attack power goes up, so he can strike for higher damage. Moving on to the next power, which is moving on to the powers. Give the weakest enemy vulnerable this turn. It's okay. It's not the greatest. It's decent for the time being. I mean, every now and then, if you have a quick attacker on the board, vulnerable on the enemy units makes a difference. Of course, when you summon a one-cost ally, granted +2/+2. Cithria is one cost, and you get him from a copy of herself. Not even from a copy of herself, reading copy of herself all the time. That's the attachment she had. So she's basically one mana 4/4, and you can continue to flood the board with it. It's pretty nice. All allies have over is pretty good, because everybody has grows over time when they strike. That's what Yasuo, one of the Yasuo's plus, especially Yasuo, if he's on the board, he will be very big with attack power. Normally they would be able to block it, but now that he has overrun, he'll always shed a big amount of damage. Round start, summon a 2-cost unit from the deck. Few of them are pretty good, specifically the Blade Warlock. This being summoned on the board for free is pretty good on the start of the game. So the strongest enemy is Yasuo's 3-star power. Extremely important, extremely strong, and pretty amazing. And this is Yasuo's 2-star power. Every game starts, you can max no mana, and whenever an ally strikes, granted +1 attack power. Only attack power, not HP. But every time they hit, they get one extra attack power. Of course, the stun strikes also count as strikes, so that's pretty good. So he grows on the board through attacking or defending, as well as stun attacking. And this is gain another stamina power. Game start, heal your nexus for 4. And of course, this is legendary rank 20 power. Game start, you draw a champion, not specifically Yasuo, any champion in your deck, you get one free draw of a champion at the start of the game. And that's about it.